Tessa Frincke, Michigan State University. Hi, Tessa, thanks for being with us in Negocios TV. It's a pleasure having you here.
Hello, thanks for having me. It's been great to be invited.
We are talking again about these three ayatollahs. Abi Loeb continues with some messages. What is the difference between three ayatollahs and two I Borisov, one I Oumuamua? What is the difference between them?
Right, so three ayatollahs is the difference between three ayatollahs and one I Oumuamua is that ʻOumuamua did not exhibit typical comet outgassing and experienced non-gravitational accelerations due to gases being trapped in amorphous ice and us not being able to see some of those outgassings. And conversely, 2I Borisov and 3I Atlas, they show the typical comet outgassing with volatile materials. But one thing that differentiates 3I Atlas from 2I Borisov is the ratio of outgassing of different volatiles. 3I Atlas shows way more like outgassing of CO2 than we saw with 2I Borisov. So it is definitely a unique interstellar object.
Talking about three ayatollahs, I would like to ask you about the speed. What about its speed and how does it compare to other interstellar objects?
Right. So, 3I Atlas was coming in from infinity at much high rate of speed. So we saw for 1I Oumuamua with only 26 kilometers per second, and a little bit faster, our 2I Borisov was at 32 kilometers per second, but almost double that speed was 3I Atlas with almost 60 kilometers per second. So we're seeing that 3I Atlas has a much greater hyperbolic velocity.
And Tessa, what do we know about the nucleus of three ayatollahs? Its size, density, its shape. What do we know about the nucleus of three ayatollahs?
So what we know about the nucleus is we will be. It's the upper limit on this is about. I believe it's 11 kilometers, but it could be different, but we will see more of those nucleus features as it has made its closest approach with the sun already. We're going to be able to see a lot closer to the nucleus once all of those materials from the surface blow off. We'll be able to see the 3I Atlas much brighter, and we'll be able to see deeper down into the nucleus. So we'll be learning more and more in the next couple of weeks or months. We do know that the surface temperature of about 150 kilometers, which indicates a number of thermal properties of 3I Atlas. And as far as like its shape, we're not really sure what it looks like, the nucleus itself.
We are talking about the speed, we are talking about the nucleus. What about the evolutionary history of this comet? What do we know about it?
Yeah, so we know that 3I Atlas has been traveling through interstellar medium for a really long time, upper limits up to 11 billion years. So we know that 3I Atlas has been through a lot coming on its way to our system, and a lot of the surface of 3I Atlas has been processed over that time, so we can tell approximately how long 3I Atlas has been being processed by like galactic cosmic rays, or been processed by interstellar dust and all of that stuff. So we can tell that based on how much the surface of 3I Atlas has been processed by cosmic rays, we can tell sort of how long it's been traveling and how long it's taken to get to us in the solar system.
Tessa, what have we learned about 3I Atlas? What are we learning about 3I Atlas, and how could help us to intercept another interstellar object in the future?
Yeah, so we've learned a lot in the past couple of months, and we've a lot of astronomers, scientists have been thinking about how we could have intercepted 3i Atlas with a spacecraft, like launching from here on Earth or launching from Mars itself, or just turning one of our current spacecraft probes just to look at it. But unfortunately, because of 3i Atlas coming in at such high rate of speed and the date at which we discovered it, limited our possibilities of really doing direct imaging with a spacecraft or doing any kind of direct imaging through flyby. So if we're able to detect a future interstellar object much earlier on, maybe when it's much farther past where we found 3i Atlas, which was near Jupiter, if we could detect the interstellar object much earlier, we can, and if we have some kind of system set up where we can turn our spacecrafts to look at 3i Atlas, or even possibly utilize projects that are in the works right now, like the ESA's comet interceptor. If we can get things like that going, we can have a better plan for when our future interstellar objects come through our system.
Isa, we are talking a lot about 3i Atlas. How many interstellar visitors are we seeing in this decade? How many 3i Atlas are we seeing in the future?
Right, so we've only seen three so far, and that's really makes this kind of object pretty rare. But honestly, I think we are just currently limited by our technology, in that if we have like the Vera Rubin telescope that just came online not long ago, and we're going to be having Nancy Grace Roman telescope come up eventually next year. So we're hoping to at least see one to ten new interstellar objects each year, considering the new technology that's coming online. But we are hopeful that we're seeing at least one more interstellar object each year.
Well, waiting for more information about 3i Atlas. Tessa, it's a pleasure having you here. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.